We have concluded that any forward edge from A to B must be saturated, and any backwards edge from B to A must be unused. Before going any further, let's illustrate this with an example. Here we have a flow on the left and the corresponding residual graph on the right. Note that there is no path from S to T in the residual graph. Let's mark the vertices we can reach from S in green and the other ones in orange. Now it's easy to see that all the edges from the green to the orange vertices are saturated, and the edges from the orange to the green are empty, just like the theorem claims. Recall that for any cut, the value of a flow is the flow out of the partition with the source minus the flow into the partition with the source. As we just argued, however, in this case there is no flow back into the source partition. Moreover, the flow saturates all the edges, so it's just the sum of the capacities across the cut from A to B, which is then defined as the cut capacity. That completes the second part of the theorem. Lastly, we need to show that the existence of a cut that has the same value as a flow implies that that flow is a maximum flow. This follows immediately from the fact that a cut is an upper bound. If it's not an upper bound, then cut capacity wouldn't be an upper bound on the value of the flow, so this would produce a contradiction. That then completes the theorem. These three things are equivalent. Maximum flow is equal to minimum capacity cut, and the Ford-Fulkerson approach returns a maximum flow.
If you followed all that, congratulations. The max flow min cut theorem is one of the classic theorems in the study of algorithms, and a wonderful illustration of duality, which we'll discuss in a later lesson. For now, however, we're not quite ready to leave maximum flow yet.